drones that act like a swarm of bees, and others that could hide from enemy radar. These are some of the latest remotely operated military aircraft in China's arsenal.
We've seen sort of an explosion of creativity from the Chinese defense industry.
And Beijing has said modernization includes building more sophisticated drones at a time of tension between the U.S. and China.
They want a military that can employ artificial intelligence, autonomous systems, and generally a lot more unmanned systems.
China's military spending is lower than the U.S., but Beijing has been dedicating a growing portion of its budget to drones and other military equipment. And while Chinese drones don't have as much battlefield experience as the American-made ones, we compare different models to see how Beijing is pushing new designs and capabilities to better equip its military for possible conflicts in the region. Since the 1930s, the U.S. military has been one of the early pioneers of unmanned aerial vehicles. Today, it flies a fleet of thousands of drones that have operated in countries including Iraq, Pakistan, and Afghanistan.
Drones are going to become very important in modern combat.
Timothy Heath has been studying China's military strategy for more than 20 years and is a senior researcher at RAND Corporation, a nonprofit organization that contributes strategic analysis to the U.S. Department of Defense. Drones offer options unavailable to manned aircraft, since they can be remotely operated or autonomously follow pre-programmed paths.
There is a low risk of human casualties. You get the ability to loiter, for example, and to use advanced sensors so you can have more precise targeting. In general, drones are lower cost than manned aircraft.
It's these capabilities that have made China interested in expanding and modernizing its own fleet.
They are building on what the U.S. military have done. The first generation of Chinese unmanned aircraft were pretty derivative of the U.S.
One of China's earliest models looks almost identical to the U.S. Predator drone and works similarly. Both are remotely controlled via satellite and can carry missiles. But China is also tweaking the design so its drones are better suited for wherever its military is likely to deploy them. Like the Global Hawk, the Chinese military says the WZ-7 is capable of operating at a high altitude to conduct surveillance missions. But the U.S. drone is larger and can fly for longer periods of time, allowing it to operate around the globe to support air and ground forces.
WZ-7 probably is going to be used mainly in the region or the maritime space in the East China Sea and South China Sea. In that area, the Chinese don't need as long an endurance.
What it does need is the ability to navigate unstable weather conditions in the region, like typhoons. So the WZ-7 is designed with two sets of overlapping wings that the Chinese military says create more airborne stability. Besides tweaking designs, China is also rethinking how many drones it can deploy at the same time. The Golden Eagle 150B can drop small bombs, and China has said it wants to use several of them simultaneously.
It's kind of like a swarm of bees where they all each individual bee knows what it must do and can make its own decisions. If one bee next to it gets killed, the others will continue swarming to sting.
China hasn't demonstrated these drones, but showed how the swarming tactic would work with another aircraft. The military hasn't said how it will manage a large network like this remotely. Drone experts say the key would be to program them with sophisticated sensors to communicate with each other, so they approach the target together while avoid crashing into one another. If the swarming drones can work in the real world, this cheaper unit could help exhaust an enemy's missile defense system. Another creative approach China is taking combines some of the best features from multiple aircraft to build something that's not in the U.S. arsenal. China's GJ-11 is a reconnaissance combat drone that has some of the features of an American B-2 bomber. For instance, a flying wing design that allows the airframe to deflect radar signals. China hasn't publicly demonstrated this drone, but he says it would probably rely more on automation, unlike the B-2 bomber, which needs two pilots on board.
Because it's flying far from Chinese command centers, it flies at a very high altitude. They would have to program in some mission parameters, and the GJ-11 would rely on navigation capabilities and target identification capabilities to carry out its strikes behind enemy lines.
There's definitely some distance between development and deployment.
Elsa Kania is an adjunct senior fellow at the nonprofit and bipartisan think tank Center for a New American Security, which received some funding from the U.S. State Department. She's been studying China's military tech innovation for about 7 years. The Chinese military hasn't used its drone in real warfare, but over the past decade, the country has exported over 200 drones to 16 countries.
They've been crashed, there have been complaints about the reliability, but as Chinese drones are used by other militaries, that the data or the insights generated from those use cases may improve their design or development going forward.
The Chinese Defense Ministry didn't respond to a request for comment. Last year, the official newspaper for the Chinese military said that drones are a new experiment and a growing trend for future combat. Kania says the newer models point to how China could eventually integrate AI and machine learning to improve performance and make them highly autonomous. But that also raises questions about the security of any AI-driven drone.
There are ways that drones can be hacked, jammed, disrupted. With increased autonomy, does come a greater risk of failures that are unexpected or of systems that are immature proving to be unreliable.
Despite all these concerns, China is quickly advancing not just the development of drones, but other parts of its arsenal. And that could increase concerns from the U.S. and its allies in the region.
With these drones, what you'll see is the Chinese will be able to respond even faster and more effectively. It's possible that a long-term effect of increased China's use of UAVs to dominate its neighbors is increased tensions between China and many of its neighbors.